Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. So today's the stop motion update for my little web series, Curse of the Wolf's Heart. And this stuff I'm going to show you today was actually shot like a few weeks ago. If you notice in my last video, you can actually see the stuff I'm building in this video, like already built in the background and stuff. I'm in the process of animating right now, so it's kind of like hard to really shoot like videos about like what I'm doing without sort of spoiling, you know, what the actual little movie will be. So I'm kind of trying to pad out my time a little more till I get that done, and then I can kind of show some more behind the scenes type stuff from actually shooting and stuff. So in this video I'm building a camera slider and then like a rig to raise the camera up and down. They both, you know, had to be a little different than like live action, like a live action slider and a live action jib, because, you know, it has to move in like tiny increments. So I had to sort of like rethink what I've seen on the web and build my own version. And anyway, this is what I came up with. My first idea was to use one of my son's toy trucks that he doesn't use anymore. I picked this green dump truck, and I took my grinder and I ground off the top of it. And that was pretty fun. If you ever wonder what's inside one of those things, there you go. And then I made a little box around it, kind of 1x4s, I think. Are they 1x4s? I'm pretty sure they were. And screwed it down, and thought that the camera could just ride along that. What I didn't really think about at the time was, you know, like the wheels on the dump truck, they had a good tread on them. So when I actually, you know, shot a little bit of test footage, there was just quite a bit of vibration in the truck, so I had to come up with a different idea. So the second part of this whole thing with the truck was when I started out, I was just being like real ambitious, and I wanted to have like this threaded rod with like a crank that I could like turn and push the car along, you know. But the threaded bar I had like just this like ever so slight bend that I didn't realize in it, which as you turned it kind of put this wave into the movement of the truck. So it added to the you know, I not only had like the bumpiness of the tires messing me up, I also had the anyway, the whole thing was just kind of like a big bust. And I spent like a kind of like the first day just making something that I had to, you know, take back apart. I think like on retrospect, you know, like the ideal way to do this would have been get some like rollerblade wheels or maybe skateboard wheels and use those. But I didn't really have anything like that, so I ended up going and finding another little tractor, Tristan's, this little green one. And it had nice smooth wheels on it. And I just took that thing all apart. The simpler design worked quite a bit better. I just screwed like a 1x4 down on top of like four wheels, and it ran like quite a bit smoother like right off the bat. The track was just upside down box, basically, made out of I think it was 1x4s and maybe like a 1x6 on top, and I just made it real smooth. And the truck ran right across, you know, right along the top real nicely. I was a little worried about just leaving my camera sitting on top of that track with like sort of nothing holding it there. When stop motion, you want your camera to be locked down and you're only moving it, you know, like a little bit each time. So I didn't want it to, you know, be just sitting there where I could bump it and it could just roll and then, you know, possibly just roll right off the track, which would be terrible. So I ended up cutting up some foam. I started with just some craft foam, and I glued that down. Once I put the car back on the track, I noticed that the foam worked really well to kind of hold the thing in place, and, you know, it gave good friction to the wheel so it wouldn't just, like, roll and could easily be just sort of positioned where you want it and it would stay there. So I went ahead and I cut some thicker foams, and I glued another layer on top there. Worked really well because then, you know, like the camera could be moved along, like, you know, inch by inch, and not, you know, roll away and be kind of held where you put it, you know. So when you pushed it a little bit, it would stay there, and you pushed it a little bit more, it would stay there, and you pushed it a little bit more, it would stay there. So that was kind of a lucky idea that I came up with. So I finished off the track with a like fabric ruler, I guess you could say, and I just glued it on with some hot glue, glued it right to the foam, and then that way I could keep track of how much I was moving, moving the truck each time. Tristan kind of demonstrating there. It works pretty well as a stop motion slider. I've probably done one, you know, done it different if it was for like live action, but it actually works real well for stop motion, and I've shot some stuff on it already, and it works well. The head there was just a, you know, cheap tripod head I picked up off of eBay. So like, what is it?
It's a rocket.
A rocket? Let's see how it works. Goes on there. Holy smokes! I went over there. Nice job. So for the camera crane, I sort of did a modified version of ones I had seen on YouTube and stuff. So I made it kind of like a vertical track out of some 2x2s that could fit like a 2x3 in between. So then I took that little setup and I installed it, like, you know, vertically inside my shed. It goes clear from the floor to the bottom of that shelf, and I just leveled it up and screwed it into place. Then I used a pretty big bit and drilled some holes all the way through both of the 1x2s so I could, like, you know, have sort of a crane arm attach right through the center there. Then I cut down some 2x3 and to be the crane arm. Then I laid them on top of each other and drilled some, you know, parallel holes so they would all match up when I put them into my, you know, frame, my vertical frame that's in there. These holes were all pretty big. They needed to be big so that it could ride on some big screws and, you know, move freely. I built a box for the head of the crane with kind of like those same kind of parallel holes, and then I kind of stuck this, what is that, like a 1x3 little platform at the bottom that kind of hold the camera out. And it didn't look like much, but it actually worked pretty well. Then I attached my crane arms into the front box. As you can see, I got a couple big bolts through there, and then I got about 3 or 4 washers on each side so that it could turn, you know, real smoothly in there. And then with quite a bit of effort, I got those center beams to go through that frame, and got those big bolts to go through there, and which was kind of a real pain in the neck by yourself, but I did get it to work and didn't have to wait for Tanya to get home to come hold something for me. And then it, you know, once it was all bolted together, it actually worked really nicely. But my problem was now I kind of had a crane that, you know, you see people build on YouTube all the time, but it's got to be able to stop, it's got to be able to hold position. So the idea I came up with to do that was to make another identical vertical frame that would kind of sit back by that back handle, and then I cut some more of the ABS floor mat foam and just cut some strips like the same size as the 1x3s, and then on the inside I hot glued that ABS foam in there, and then when I put it up in the shed, I sandwiched the handle between those two pieces. And I thought, you know, when I was making it, that, you know, that would slow it down enough that I could, you know, put a bungee cord around it or something like that to sort of hold it. But what was really cool is once I sandwiched that tight, you know, that foam compressed, and then you could actually move the crane to like a certain level and it would just like stay there. And it worked worked really, really well. I'm sure I'll, you know, still sort of like stabilize it and lock it off as I move it, but yeah, the whole thing actually turned out pretty good.
It's funny because I thought this was going to be the hard one to build and the slider was going to be easy. Slider was a real pain in the butt, and I actually had to do it 3 times to make it work. And this one actually went together pretty easy in just in a day. So anyway, I'm looking forward to trying it out. So check me out on Patreon if you want to support my project. And that's it. See you guys next time.